give life balance and meaning. Lan Yang takes time out of the day for her music. She's a professor in the Department of Electrical and Systems Engineering at the McKelvey School of Engineering at Washington University in St. Louis. Yang often tells the story of her journey from China to St. Louis. Her motivation is as natural as playing the zither.
I wanted something that can change the world, do things that can really make a world a different one because of me.
A mission she explained she willfully began as a young girl in China. Growing up in the Hunan province of China, she said most girls didn't go to high school. Instead, they attended professional schools that may guarantee them a nice job. She was scheduled to go to a professional school. It was her mom's wish.
My mom said, don't even think about the high school application.
But instead, Yang took a stand.
So I told my mom, if you force me to go there, I will go to a hunger strike. For the whole day, I don't eat anything. My parents were scared. They just want to find a safe choice for me.
In fact, she needed approval to get into high school. Fortunately, she got it. Eventually, she left China for California, receiving her PhD from Caltech before a successful career at Washington University in St. Louis.
My focus is to make a micro laser on silicon wafer that can be used for communication. After becoming a faculty at WashU, I got more and more passionate about research in medical technology.
For her inventions, she holds an impressive number of patents.
Yang is leading the way for women. She has 7 patents, which is the most patents among female faculty at Washington University, with dozens more pending, and she has more than 100 published papers.
Her recent success involves optical technologies. She devised an optical resonator system that can be used in the management of air quality for the detection of harmful nanoparticles in the air.
It will allow you to see just one molecule. We can precisely measure the particle size down to 50 nanometer. Our lung cannot filter such a small particle.
Yang says she's most passionate about using optical resonators for the creation of portable biosensors for advanced early detection of various diseases. She's now wanting to create an ultra-sensitive virus detector to detect those infected with coronavirus before they show symptoms.
Physically detect those existing virus particle around the person.
From the individual's breath when they exhale.
Instead of just checking the temperature, because it's not enough anymore.
The work will need to involve more researchers to develop. Wuhan is close to the home where she grew up, the high school where she succeeded.
My hometown, they still use me as an example to show, because they see these girls can do so many things beyond what we imagine.
Yang is achieving her career goals while fulfilling other dreams. She's married with 3 daughters. At times, she brings her kids to the office and gives them something to do, all the while flourishing in her role.
Because people here, they're so supportive. They make me feel like I'm in a big family. It's not just a job. It's a family. I think it's very important to give women the message, to help them, you know, we are here to support you. Give women the kind of flexibility, the kind of support. I think that is real helpful.
And she creates balance. Playing the zither is only one of her hobbies. There's another her family and friends enjoy as well. Yang's edible creations. Having a supportive family has made all the difference. As for her mom, she stayed by Yang's side.
My mom is really proud. Finally, you know what my mom told me the other day? He said, I'm so happy you were stubborn at that moment. You had on your dream, I'm so proud of you now. You have my full support. Every single person born with talents, but it's you. You self have the responsibility for yourself to find out what your true talent is. For me, doing science is to do something to help the people, to make the community a better one.